Do you give monthly statements to your customers? Well, if you don't, then you should. And I'm going to show you how to do that in QuickBooks Online. A monthly statement is a document that we periodically give to the customers who owe us money. It's like a legal declaration or even an assertion of what they must pay us, and it explains why. So why do we give customers a monthly statement? There are three simple reasons. First, we have to make sure that we agree with the customer what the customer's balance was on exactly the statement date. Secondly, we must agree with the customer regarding how all transactions have been recorded. And third, this will help reconcile any differences between our records and the customer records regarding any transactions that happened between us during the statement dates. So you may well ask, what's on a customer statement? Well, that depends on the type of statement you give. And there are three kinds of statements you can give to your customer, and we're going to explore each of them right now. Now, the first kind of statement is the easiest. It's called a transaction statement, and it's simply a list of every transaction that you had with your customer during the time period of the statement. So let's do an example. Let's send our great customer, Alan, a monthly statement for the month of January 2025. That means the beginning date will be January 1, and it will include all transactions from January 1 to January 31 of 2025. From the top left, we click New. We go across to the column of Other, and then we go down and click Statement. Now, I'm filming this very far in the past, but you can click the calendar box and use the calendar box to put in our example date, January 31 of 2025. Or you could highlight the date and type in the date range yourself. Now, you can pause the video if you need a moment to click here, but the most important thing to choose, and in this first example, we choose from the list transaction statement, is this type of statement, transaction statement, which is simply a list of all the transactions we've had with this customer between these two dates. We click apply and we see that there are statements available. Now we can click the check mark next to the customers whom we don't want to see. And when we have Alan selected for the specific dates that we want, only he should be checked off when we go down and click Preview. Now we see Alan's statement in the display window. And of course, if you scroll down, you can see that with Alan, these are the only transactions that we had with him during the month of January of 2025. And it simply lists them in date order. We had these invoices and these sales receipts. And it tells you the amount received if, in fact, it's an invoice or even a payment. So let's close it out. Now, the second type of statement we can send is called an open item statement. That's because it shows a list of every currently open invoice as of the statement date. And when it lists it, it shows every invoice that's open, it shows the original amount of each invoice, and the remaining amount unpaid. Well, it's very simple. Leave the date choices and date ranges, leave the customer selected, and simply change the statement type. And in this example, we choose open item statement to open item statement. Now we click apply and we see that all three customers have statements available for that date.
We click to remove the check mark on the ones that we don't want to see, and we want to see only Alan for the statement date up here that we're requesting. Once we chose everything correctly, click Preview, and you can see that during January, Alan only had 3 invoices, and here are the original amounts, and here are the amounts that remained open as of the statement date. Notice number 7 is completely paid off, but number 5 and number 13 are only mostly paid off, so this statement would clearly indicate to Alan exactly what remains unpaid at the end of the month.
Now, the third type of statement that we're going to learn is called a balance forward statement. This is also a statement that shows a list of transactions between the dates. The only difference is this one shows the balance at the beginning, the balance at the end of the statement period, and this one also shows something called a running balance. And a running balance means the last column shows what the balance is after each transaction listed in date order. That's very important for finding and fixing mistakes and making sure you know what mistakes happened in a prior period and what mistakes happened during this statement period.
So again, all you have to do is if you selected the statement window and you selected the customer whose statements you want to see, just make sure you chose the right statement date.
And in this last example, we choose balance forward statement.
And the right statement type. In this case, balance forward. Notice when you choose balance forward, you need more than just the statement date. You need the start date and end date of the statement. When we click preview, you can see just for actually what just happened, I left these check marks here. So if you click print or preview, it's going to show all 3, Alan's, Betty's, and Candy's. But if we look at Alan's, you can see that during the month of January 2025, okay, because this starts on December 31 of 2024, that means these are all the transactions that happened during 2025. And you can clearly see it lists every transaction and the effect on the balance. An invoice for $3,000 means we owe $3,000. Another invoice means we owe more. Another invoice, we owe more. Another payment, the balance gets lower. A sale receipt does not change the balance. Another sale receipt does not change the balance. But the next invoice changes the balance, and so on. And of course, you could print it, and you could email these statements. If you want to email a statement instead of print or preview, all you have to do is put the person's email address right here and click Save and Send, and it will be sent to the customer as a PDF attachment right in their email.